welcome to this very special edition of Real Talk About Real Estate with Peter and Nicole. What's so special, Peter?
Well, we're down here at our brand new Hamilton office, downtown Hamilton. We're at James Street North and Barton. We just moved in here on Monday, and we're very excited to start having people in here to check out our new spot once things open up. It's a very exciting spot. All the great restaurants down here at Barton and James Street North. Great people watching, and we're excited to be here.
Yeah, it's a really cool spot. I'm like, not just location-wise, but it's bright and shiny in here. Very what I imagine Google to be like, to work from, open and hip, if I'm allowed to use that word.
Yeah.
But yeah, you know what else is really exciting? The latest stats.
Let's get into it. So finally, after a little while of people waiting for the inventory to catch up to the number of new sales, we've got a bit of a different stat for you. So February compared to January, we had a 63% increase in the number of listings and only a 52% increase in the number of sales. So finally, that inventory percent caught up to the number of sales.
Those are big numbers. And what I found especially interesting was the fact that the increase in number of new listings was a good chunk greater than the increase in number of sales, as opposed to being the reverse, what we saw for much of, going on a year now. What do you make of that, those indicators?
It's tough to say specifically, but what I think it is we're in an early spring market, so the weather's getting much nicer. We've got a beautiful sunny day today. We've had a few in the last few weeks, and that helps people get ready to list. Also, the wave of people coming from Toronto, it's now turned into more of a wave of people leaving Waterdown, Hamilton, Burlington, putting their houses up for sale and moving out of town. A lot of people are cashing out because of the high prices and pulling their nest egg out. And a lot of people are making good money, like retirement money, by selling their houses and moving further out of town to capitalize on the less expensive real estate elsewhere. That's my guess, but it's tough to say for sure.
Well, I think the increase in new listings that we're seeing, all very good points, by the way. I think, yeah, nicer weather tends to bring more listings out. People like it when their landscaping is looking better, not so much snow to trudge around in. I also think not being in lockdown, for one, made it more enticing to put your house on the market. And just the general sense, you know, vaccinations are starting to roll out. So I think there's a bit more confidence, yeah. Optimism, that sort of thing. So, more options is great. To be able to, you know, not have to wait and wait for another house to come on. Now we're seeing, showing a few houses at one time,
oh
which
my
hasn't,
goodness. Rather hasn't than happened. One a week when it comes up.
Yeah.
You're able to take people out for three or four at a time.
Yeah.
And actually see the market. What do you say we do a little fact or fiction?
You betcha.
I've got one for you.
Okay.
A lot of people are buying houses sight unseen because of the crazy market, or maybe they're branching out to areas that they're unfamiliar with. That's got to be a terrible idea, right? Buying a house sight unseen?
Fiction. I think most people would agree that, you know, the natural reflex is to not want to buy a house sight unseen. But I just had clients who a couple of days ago did do just that, and it was a situation that it made sense in. The house was less than a year old, so still under warranty and all that.
Sure.
They're quite familiar with the area, also quite familiar with the nature of the market. So they been battling it out for a little bit. We did end up seeing the house after they bought it, and we all walked away feeling like they had just won the lottery.
Awesome.
Because they did very, very well based on the strategy that we implemented. So yeah, while it's never the ideal to buy a house sight unseen, yeah, it can make perfect sense in unique situations, and this was definitely one of them. Clients are very, very happy.
Yeah, we've been seeing that more and more, and I've done it with some clients. If you're moving, let's say you're going 2 hours out and the market's super hot, that house is going to sell within hours or in a matter of days. It's tough to get out there, but let's say you've already been to that area and you've seen the same model or very similar house, or mm-hmm, you know the builder. You're really not taking that much of a risk because mm-hmm, the difference in houses isn't that much, and the gain on getting your offer in early far outweighs the risk in some cases, of course. Yeah.
Yeah. In my case, we avoided competing altogether, and it perfect, was such a breath of fresh air. And they're stoked. Okay, your turn. Fact or fiction? In the kind of market that we're in, the idea of being able to buy a house without it going to the open market has become somewhat of a pipe dream.
That's also fiction. It's so hard to buy a house that's on the market right now, and you would think it would be a godsend if you could buy something on the open market. Almost too good to be true, but the truth is, we're doing it all the time. We just had an agent not from our team email our team saying, I've got this listing coming up. Would you happen to have any buyers? I happen to have a buyer for it. We brought them through before it went to MLS, brought them a good offer, and it was accepted. And they didn't have to deal with the craziness of competing. Now, you're not going to get a deal on these off-market listings, but you're going to save yourself the pain of being up against 5, 10, 15 offers, however hot that property ends up being. And also with a team like ours, we're listing plenty of houses every week, and we're giving our buyers the opportunity to go through those listings before they go to MLS as often as we can. There are a lot of sellers that don't want to have 50 people through their house over a weekend, and we'll gladly take an offer without having that kind of traffic through their house, and having to walk around Walmart for their entire Saturday because it was the only thing to do during lockdown, and there's not much more to do right now.
So point being, there are still great opportunities to be had.
Absolutely.
As long as you know how to dredge them up.
Exactly.
All right. I think that's about a wrap.
That's a great wrap. And remember, if you don't run the day, the day's going to run you.
Boom.